Marina, first off, congratulations on your win.
Thank you.
Let's start off with your entrance look. What inspired you to do a look inspired by Hattie Valera's
tapos? Yeah.
Ano yung naging inspiration mo at ano yung naging decision mo? Ano yung paano yung naging process mo to decide on that look?
Yeah, for, you know, one of the most important looks that you need to bring into the competition is the entrance look. So I wanted to make a statement. I was the first Filipina to be ever on that show, to be in Drag Race UK, let alone, and to be the first Filipina drag queen to represent the homeland, the Philippines, on an international all-stars. So with that in mind, and the context of UK versus the world, I wanted to, you know, take it back to our history, and kagaya nga nung sabi ko sa promo, I really want to make sure na I represent not only just Marina, but, you know, the entire country, and digmaan siya eh. Itong All-Stars na to, itong UK versus the world, digmaan siya. So I wanted to look the part.
After the no, when you met all the queens, sino yung pinaka na intimidate ka or na feel mo na threat?
Honestly, Mayhem Miller. Because she's such a legend in the States. She does a lot of shows. She books us in the US as well. And she's been in the game for a very long time. And also Kata Minaj from Drag Race Holland, because I watched her in her season and I was obsessed with her. And she was chopped right before the finale after having 3 wins. So I knew from then on that they're going to be competition.
In the opposite side naman, sino yung parang na-excite ka nung nakita mo sila na pumasok sa surrounding?
Honestly, like Grand Dame, because I saw a bit of her from her season because of her runways, and that's my favorite part of the show, the runways. And I really, 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 I was really thrilled to see the runways in person, Nila Grand Dame, so I'm really excited.
So let's talk about your talent.
Yes.
So, first, what made you decide to choose Haba Kabog as the song? And paano yung naging process on creating your own lyrics?
Mm-hmm. The idea of Ama Kabogera, of doing a rendition to Ama Kabogera, didn't come to us up until, let's say, late December or late November. Late December, right? Yeah, late December. 2022.
Yes.
2022? 2023?
Two.
Yeah, oh my god, we filmed pala 2022. 2023, okay. Anyways, so it didn't come until late December 2022. But I've always wanted to do a rendition of Ama Kabogera, because I love B-pop, and Maymay is one of my favorite local artists. So, and yung Ama Kabogera, pang bakla talaga siya, girl. Diba? Pang bakla talaga siya, even from the title itself, diba? So, I wanted to pay homage to that and do my own rendition to it. Like, how would the gays do it? How would the drag queens portray it? How would we sing it on an international level? So, yeah, I'm really, really happy na we were able to work it out, especially with Camp Summers. Kasi parang nasa ano kami, actually, nasa racket kami noon. Tapos, at may isang racket noon na in-invite ako to guest perform in their show. And ang performance was Ama Kabogera. Tapos, I don't know if she's watching this or I'm not makakarating sa kanya to. Pero, nung nag-rehearse kami, sinasabi niya, Ama Kabogera! Okay, 1, 2, 3, Ama Kabogera! Ganun siya magsalita. So, until umakyat kami sa hotel room namin, iniisip namin yung Ama Kabogera, minamok namin. I'm really sorry. But that really sparked the idea of Ama Kabogera into Ama Filipina. So, doon nag-start, in that very small room, doon nabuo yung concept ng fire dancing, ng B-pop, ng original Filipino music. So, kinontak agad namin yung friends namin from Star Music, ABS-CBN Music. It was a long, long process because it's such an iconic song. But I am very, very, very honored na nabigyan ako ng chance to do a rendition of the song.
And after your performance, grabe yung reaction ng queen sa'yo.
Yeah.
Kami to drink your coffee when she said na she's really nervous after
yes.
your performance because she feels threatened
yes.
with your performance. And from that moment on, she said that you're one of the pieces to look out for in the competition. How does it feel that I'm watching it earlier? How does it feel that to get that reaction from the other queens?
Honestly, when we were filming it, I really felt that because what they didn't show in the episode, because we don't have that much time to show it in the episode, is that even in the backstage, even in the workroom, everyone was a Filipina because everyone was singing, I'm a Filipina, Filipino winner. So lahat kami kumakanta, even producers, even writers, even yung mga queens. You're a Filipina, you're a Filipina. Everyone's a Filipina that night. So to get that reaction in itself, and to see the episode today, sobrang nakaka-validate siya, not only as an artist, but also as a Filipina na, oh my God, gusto nila maging Pilipino. Kasi yung mga Pilipino, gusto natin magmukhang Banyaga, di ba?
Yes.
Pero lahat sila, like, they bow down. They treat Filipina as a royalty, so.
Dandahanin natin na. So, from the moment you were called as one of the top or bottom queens of the week, what were you feeling at that moment?
I knew I did great. That episode, no doubt. I knew I was gonna be in the top. But not top two though. I knew I was gonna be in the top. Cause, yun nga, based dun sa reception dun sa talent show ko, and ako lang yung nag-power dance, so I knew I was able to, you know, stick out from the rest of the girls. And also the runway, it's very, you know, cultural, and you can never go wrong with representing where you came from.
Let's talk about that. What made you choose yung Banao, ano? Yung look ba inspired by the farmers from Banao Rice?
Yeah, when we were selecting looks for this season, we really wanted to represent not only just, you know, the typical Filipiniana, typical terno. We wanted to go deeper. And as someone who grew up, kagaya ng sabi ko sa confessionals ko, as someone who grew up in the province, sa mga palayan, ganyan, I really wanted to represent that. Bata pa lang ako, nagsusuot na ako ng mga cultural attires, baha, ganyan, for my cultural performances. So I really wanted to bring that aspect. And I wanted a personal truth in that runway, in that home country look. I wanted personal truth in that. That's why it translated sa runway. Hi, MJ!
And then after that, parang ano yung na-feel mo na sobrang grabe yung critique sa'yo ng mga judges, including Alan Carlos, of your runway was very educational.
Yes.
So how does it feel to get that kind of comment? Especially when RuPaul said that you're making your country proud.
Yeah, I mean, sobrang sarap sa feeling na they feel like it's educational. Kasi part ng identity natin yung rice. Part ng identity natin yung agriculture. And I just really wanted to represent that on that specific runway. And nag-translate siya, even to foreigners. So, ganong kalakas yung culture natin, yung heritage natin. And, you know, getting all the comments from them. Actually, meron pa isang comment doon na left out. Sobrang ingit na ingit si RuPaul sa waist ko. Hindi na nila sinama. Kasi masyado na marami silang mas magagandang sinabi sa akin. Pero yeah, I'm really, really, really happy nung narinig ko yung mga critiques. Especially with the performance. Yeah, sarap sa feeling.
When you got the top two spot, and now performing like Western songs,
yeah.
Ano yung nararamdaman mo at that moment? Especially you were up against the Gundam, who you said earlier na parang ano, natuwa ka to see.
Well, I was scared for anyone who's gonna go against me on a lip sync. So I'm not really worried, even though kahit ano pa yan, kahit Spanish song pa yan, kahit Western song pa yan. I don't care. I was born a performer, so I'm gonna die as a performer. So if I'm gonna die on that main stage performing, so be it. But I wasn't the one who was murdered on that main stage. But yeah, honestly, ang pinaka exciting part of that is to actually perform in front of RuPaul, lip syncing to a foreign song, to a song that, you know, anyone couldn't perform. Because I'm a Filipina, ako lang pwede mag-perform, no, diba? But you know, just perform in front of RuPaul is just a big, 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 big task to do. And also, apart from doing good in the lip sync, you also have to think of the decision that you're gonna make, di ba? Kailangan ko bang galingan para mapauwi ko to or hindi ko masyadong gagalingan para hindi ko mapauwi to? Parang ganon, you know, it's all about strategy and everything. So, kagaya ng anong sabi ni RuPaul, great power comes great responsibility. So, yeah, it was a little bit hard.
And when
so.
You heard that you're a winner, baby, does it feel Ah, grabe yung nga mo, parang, when we were saying na parang, ganga ng Miss Universe na
lang. No, because really, when you're performing on that stage, or any lip sync, battle, kahit nung season 1 namin sa Drag Race Philippines, hindi ko talaga alam kung anong nangyayari sa kalaban ko, kung anong ginagawa niya. And especially for this one, hindi ko alam yung full repertoire ni La Grande Dame sa lip-syncing skills niya. So, hindi ko alam, is she gonna do comedy, is she gonna dance? But whenever I perform, nagba-blackout talaga ako, nakikita ko lang ilaw. So, I really didn't care so much. But when they called my name, grabe. Ganon talaga, Miss Universe talaga.
Meron bang off-cam moments kayo ni RuPaul? Because what we only saw is just what was aired.
Yeah.
Pero meron bang moments that we had nakausap ko siya, namitin siya, everything?
Aww. Apart from her gagging over my waist, yun lang, yun talaga yung pinakatumatak sa akin that episode na hindi nasama sa cut. But yeah, we don't have that much opportunity to talk to her off cam, but we're on but when we're rolling, we get to talk to her naman.
Was she under the weather?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Even kahit nung entrance pa lang niya, she told us na she's not feeling well. So that's hence the voice.
Right.
But yeah, she's a professional through and through.
Right.
She was there to make a TV show, and so she did. Sorry? Even just by hearing RuPaul say my name,
yeah.
Marina Summers,
yeah.
Sobrang surreal niya for me. And to be even called Marina Summers, you're a winner, baby.
Yeah.
Like, I'm a Filipino winner!
Sana next time yung crowd lane ako
ba? Yes, why not, diba? That's what we came there for, diba?
Pero Marina, you're the first Filipina drag.
Yes.
International
franchise. Yes, yes. I am the first Filipina to ever compete in an international franchise from the Philippines, from Drag Race Philippines. But we've seen a lot of our fellow Filipina sisters compete and be judged by Ru. But this is the first time that we have a homegrown, home-based queen to, you know, compete internationally. So it was such an honor for me. Ayan. Yeah, it was an honor for me.
Thank you.
Yay, thank you. We can.